So the first step in stopping that was to stop the glorification of busy. Stop allowing busyness to be used as social capital. We're going to talk about strategies and ways to take this with you, how to slow yourself down, but also to bring this message with you into the world around you, because as you know, to create change, it takes a ripple effect, and we can start that ripple effect in different communities that we interact with. But for me, the biggest thing was acknowledging that busyness is something that I clung to avoid the things that made me uncomfortable or scared. I was too busy to start my website for a year and a half. I found reasons over and over again to not start my website. I was too busy to not use this space and try doing this stuff for almost 5 years. I wanted to be a public speaker my entire life, and after I moved to Madison, I'm like, I'm going to do it, this is where I'm going to do it. I found an excuse every single time why I had too many other things that had to take priority. When nothing slows down, nothing's changed, I just shifted my priorities. But the scary part here is, what if I fail? What if I try to be an artist and I can't sell anything or no one likes my work? What if I do public speaking and nobody shows up? And that was a very real thing for me about an hour before this started. Like, what if I'm talking to an empty camera room area? So ask yourself, what might be the reason that busyness has been a coping mechanism for me? You know, is there conversations that could be really difficult with people that we love or care about that we're avoiding having by being too busy? Are there things that we really want to be doing or stuff that we really need to take care of that we're so scared about what could happen that we wear busyness as the cape?